The Nigerian sachet economy, sachetization, coined from the word sachet, refers to the sale of goods in the smallest possible units. Sachetization is the response of entrepreneurs and businesses to the growing level of poverty in the society, which has impacted buyers' purchasing power. From food items to laundry, sanitary, water, and other essentials, sachetization has become the order of the day. Businesses that fail to jump on this bandwagon face the risk of revenue loss and eventual closure. While sachetization might be an innovative idea for businesses, it is a reflection of the degree of poverty in the country. Average real income of many households have significantly dropped in the past years as we experienced double-digit inflation. This has had a multiplier effect on the economy. It's a call on the government at all levels to create an enabling environment for businesses to thrive and the economy to grow.
So I
completely understand. So what do you think, guys?
I just couldn't hold my laughter. This is so funny. You know, I love that word, sachetization. And I think, you know, when a certain brand was going to, I think it was Four Cousins, and someone said there's now one cousin, you know, in sachet, you know. You know, so I, again, it reveals the level of the poverty, you know, in the system, right? Of course, it looks like innovation where, oh, hi guys, you know, we now have our product in sachet, it's now quick, it's easy to use and all of those things. Why that buzz might be very, that phrase might be very, very interesting and a bit sexy, but the truth is, we are gradually on a time bomb.
Yeah.
So we're slipping into, like, there's a lot of problems making people do that. So we need to fix, and I agree with Ruth's ending caption, which is create an enabling environment for businesses to thrive. You know when they say, oh, there are no jobs, and we come out from school, there are no jobs, go and become an entrepreneur. But it's not enabling environment for you to even thrive as an entrepreneur. So it's even about fixing the trigger to, you know, so some innovation might not really be good innovation, so to speak. It's a function of, well, there's no money, so I'm just going to innovate to make it look like it's frenzy. So I think I understand. When we begin to go all sachetization, everything sachet, everything sachet, and then we're gradually on a time bomb without even realizing it. So the real trigger is fixing the lack of enabling environment, and it's really important.
Yeah, I'll actually not call it innovation, it's actually adaptation. So you see
reaction.
The problem.
Yeah,
reaction. Yeah, you're not innovating. You're not innovating.
That's it. It's adaptation.
Yeah. Just so it's
the
really
Nigerian context.
Yeah, exactly.
So
the truth of the matter is that word is a very powerful one. I believe it because the Nigerian situation, businesses are trying to survive around it, adapt to the situation. But the question is, to what extent can these businesses thrive in this situation? It will lead to even sometimes reducing the quality of those things.
Yeah,
of course.
Just because they want to meet up, after all, they're not going to pay much. Let's just manage. But how long are we going to become comfortable in this kind of situation? The government should try that as much as possible to invest in social security. Food, other things, businesses and others, and even drugs. Make sure things are done. Things that needed to be done should be done so that the country can thrive. We can't just be happy, suffering and smiling in the local parlance, suffering and smiling. That's what Fela will say. And we are all okay. No, we are not okay. Let's just do something about it. Well, I still applaud the businesses for actually adapting to the situation.
Yeah. To be frank,
to go beyond that.
You're very right. I think what even triggered this entire topic for me was that I went somewhere. And I was looking for a particular item.
Yeah.
And this is an item that you typically, you would never find in sachets.
Mm.
And I got there, and this was really a very poor community. I asked around for the main item, I couldn't find. All they had was the sachet. And in my head, I'm like, what happened? Like, this is just, like, this is an essential item. How come it's just in sachets?
Mm.
It just tells you that people cannot afford to buy things in bulk anymore. Mm. And there was a time I saw a picture of people selling yam slices.
Mm.
So I'm sure that they were selling, I mean, cut yam in the market, yam slices in the market. So it just shows you that there is a level of poverty in the country. That as Victor said, it's a time bomb. We are really sitting on a time bomb right now, and it needs to be fixed as quickly as possible, whatever it takes. And it all starts with creating an environment where businesses can thrive. As much as I applaud socialists, but I also always believe that an economy can grow well if there are businesses, if there are companies that can create jobs. Because at the end of the day, you only earn money from jobs or if you're doing your own business. So if there are companies that will create jobs, and those companies have to be protected. They shouldn't be stifled. There shouldn't be policies that would stop them from functioning. Exactly. They have to be protected because they are like our saving grace right now in this country. And so whatever it takes, the government has to work on building an environment where the economy, where the businesses can actually thrive. As the businesses thrive, they employ more people, and as they employ more people, the economy will begin to bust. That's simple economics 101.
Like this, I mean, it's no brainer. I think water is really angry right now. I mean, sachet water is like, you guys are competing with me. I'm supposed to be the only sachet.
Exactly. It's only sachet started with water, but now everything is in sachets. Everything.
So water must really be angry. But I think that, like Ruth said, policy is critical. It comes back to policy. There's a certain sector of the business or the sector of the economy that is really feeling the heat with the policy, you know, stifling the business operations. And I mean, just what we want to do is to build viable ideas. Young entrepreneurs want to solve problems, right? And we want to scale those problems to becoming solutions and creating businesses out of those problems. Because I interact with these people, right? I mean, that's nothing wrong to do. We just want to do that. Give us the structure, and that's where you have the japa thingy. People are, you know, exiting because you know, someone called me from the UK and said, Victor, I mean things are built here, I work here, I see my money, I work for 10 hours a week, like I see value, I enjoy, things are working, the tax system is working, the roads are working, electricity is, everything is working, right? So if things are working, Nigeria has aggressive intellectual people that can push this country to the next level. I mean, what did Dubai do, really, if you think about it? I mean, it's no brainer, right? We have the intellect. It's not rocket science. So let's just get the system to work, put the structures, put the system, create policies that enables growth.
And then thank you.
This problem is not only applicable to Nigeria, it's mostly most African countries.
Yeah. And every poor country in the world in general. So, thank you guys for this. So, Elijah wraps up the conversation after the break. Please stay tuned.